as interesting as possible. Now, if I were an abstract expressionist, I would be painting much more vigorously and with big brushes and light, but I'd still be doing the same thing. But I'm a little slower than that. I like to find very specific shapes. And I might change this a million times before it's finished. Sometimes you have to go right over what you've already painted because you need to get a white in that spot. I'll have to go back and adjust that later.
Is there a limit to the number of colors you should use?
No, as long as each time you put it on, you balance them. You really want to. So the paint, if you're working abstractly, the whole, each color should work independently and be placed by itself. And each dark, medium, and light should be organized. And then it should all work as a whole. So you should be able to look at any color and see the balance sequence. That's what people find the most interesting in a lot of my work. They can look at the color balance and really see how that works in a painting. But what happens is they automatically learn that that's an important part of composition, and they see that happening in other people's work, and they realize, gee, they should not have put all the blue in the corner. They should have moved that around in the painting. So they get a little bit spoiled. They start to see what's wrong with everyone's paintings, so, which can be a bad thing.